हाँ, तुम शो ही नहीं हो रही हो यहाँ पे। ठीक है ठीक है, आज वेटिंग। हाँ ठीक है, आ जाओ।
A very good evening to all of you joined us today on this occasion of Dussehra. So I want to wish everybody who have joined us today a very happy Dussehra to you and your whole family. May this coming year be prosperous and full of success for all of you. On behalf of Home Team Homeopathy 360 and Kavita Holistic Approach Study Group, I would like to welcome you all to this webinar series day one. So before I begin the session and then welcome you all as well as our dignitaries and esteemed speaker of the day, I want to welcome you all hearty from the core of my heart. I, Dr. Yashika Arora, will be the moderator for today's session for all of you. So as you all know that this is a webinar series on homeopathy, a holistic healing by Team Homeopathy 360 as well as CAR study group Kavita Holistic Approach. So I would like to introduce you to the to Kavita Holistic Approach study group as well as I would like to introduce you in short about Homeopathy 360 before we begin the session as well as about the software for all those people who have joined us for the very first time on this webinar jam software. I would like to update you that you have a chat box on your screens wherein you can type your queries and send to us by pressing the button next to the box. Also, you can raise your hand if you want to share your video or audio. You can share raise your hand if we'll have time. We'll surely be accepting the request and giving you the chance to interact with the speaker. I want to know that are we audible to all of you? Can you please type in the chat? I think somebody commented that there is no video or sound. Can you please comment? I want to request the audience and confirm. Thank you so much, Dr. Poonam ma'am. Can you hear us? Can you hear me and see us? Okay, great. Thank you so much. I think Dr. Tong, you need to refresh again to join to listen. There must be some connectivity issue with your PC or mobile. Ma'am, Dr. Kavita, ma'am, are you also not able to hear or listen?
No, I can
So,
hear. I
yeah,
can hear.
okay, fine. Fine. Then it's great. You commented, no? So, thank you so much. So, we'll just begin the session. So, as you all know, that Kavita Holistic Approach brings light to your life is working to promote homeopathy as well as promote homeopathic knowledge throughout the world. So, I would like to present thanks to the CAR family and study group and all the members, the core members and the team members of the whole group who have been supporting as well as promoting this series and giving Homeopathy 360 an opportunity to collaborate with CAR study group. That's a blessing. In fact, I would say that's a privilege for us to organize this webinar series with you people. I hope this would be a grand success. So before I begin and tell you, I just want to I want to request each one of you that to please visit the website of Homeopathy 360, www.homeopathy360.com. That is an online portal for publication of all kinds of course material. As well as if you want to get your articles published, any news, any voice you want to raise against homeopathy, any event you want to get updated about, or anything you want to know about homeopathy, we try to our level best to update on this website. So kindly visit the same and follow us on our social portals. It is always great to connect with you all. And now I think it's high time that I should introduce you to the organizers as well as to the lady herself who is behind this webinar series. And also I would like to present my thanks to Mr. Manish Jain, the director of Vision Publishers, who is working hard since long and during this lockdown have organized this webinar series. And this is the first time that we are organizing a series with CAST Study Group. So as you all know, Dr. Kavita Kokunur, ma'am, it's my privilege, in fact, to introduce her. I have known her in this year 2020 only, and it was great to meet her this January during our seminar in Delhi. She visited India, so it was great for me to know her in this year of 2020 when many of the bad situations have come up and things are not good. So it was a great thing for me to meet her and know her. So as you all know, she graduated BHMS from a professional homeopathic medical college, government JSPS, government homeopathic medical college, which is affiliated to University of Health Sciences, Andhra Pradesh. And she started practicing homeopathy since 1995. And she's currently located in Michigan as a practicing homeopath. She was honored with BHMS degree and started her homeopathic practice first in India, conducted free consultations at various places, as well as she has been working in the clinics of Dr. Janardhan Reddy sir, Dr. Balram sir, Dr. Gopal Krishna sir, Dr. AC Reddy sir. And then she moved to USA in 1998, but did not stop her practice and her continuous education in homeopathy. She went through all the required policies, procedures, and exams for acquiring certified classical homeopath from Board of CHC, which is an NCCA accredited. And now she became a proud member institute, which is a proud member institute for credentialing excellence. She's also a registered member of NASH, that is the North American Society of Homeopaths, which entitles her highly qualified professional designation, which is internationally accepted as RS Home NA. And she's also the president and CEO of Kavita Holistic Approach, and also the founder of CAS Homeopathy Study Group. And she has served Homeopathy World Community pro bono for 10 years as administrator, advisor, president, and COO from 2018 to 2020. And she's also the outreach coordinator of CHC PR committee and also the certified HP supervisor in Homeo Profile Access from Free and Healthy Children International. She's also LMHI member and also a board certified alternative medical practitioner from American Association of Alternative Medicine, and also a lifetime member of National Center for Homeopathy. And she has won so many awards. She has organized so many webinars, seminars, and working so hard as well as from the core of her heart that she is so much dedicated to homeopathy that she is an inspiration for many of the homeopaths, especially all the female homeopaths. I must say that after so many things, also she has gained so much and she has achieved this in her life. So I would like to welcome her, as well as I want to give her give you all a message from her on this Dashera. So I'll just play that recording first. So I would like to welcome ma'am, and I hope my screen is visible to all of you.
Yes, the doctor. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
A great lady doing so many things, and thank you, homeopathy.
Hello, Manishji and Dr. Yanashika. Happy Navratri and Dasara to everyone, and happy Thanksgiving in advance. Hope you are all doing well in this pandemic crisis and unprecedented times. I want to thank sincerely Manishji, the Managing Director, and Dr. Yanashika, Managing and Associate Director, and Homeopathy 360 King, FAKA Homeopathy Study Group team, providing this great opportunity of sharing holistic approaches of healing through energy medicine. I congratulate and many more with the best online services. I'm so glad to meet Manishi and Yashita this past January at HPWFSC Conference, New Delhi, India. And thank you for being with Manishi and Yashita. I welcome you to my presentation and sharing of my experience throughout 25 years. Let me share my screen. Dr. Yashika has given beautiful description. Thank you so much, Yashika. You have covered everything which you have put it here. However, with the impact of healing children to Samuel Hanuman, giving us the philosophical and holistic way of learning by groupings from my perspective. So glad to be a panel at JSC 28 conference in Phoenix, speaking about addressing clients for a thriving practice. Today, I would like to speak a couple of things. This alphabetical, philosophical, inspiring words. I hope it's there's not a philosophical words. Learning remedies from these topics is today's final considerations and some questions. So with experience of 3 years in homeopathy practice, the purpose of life, of our existence, that I thought like, let me come up with some philosophical things. And in all this, several webinars, yeah, I gained so much information gained on the basic conditions, remedies, and so much.
Ma'am, I want to request that there are some issues with the speaker and audio in the recording. So, can we take the webinar? And by the time you can speak, I'll just show you your slide.
Yes. So I will start. I think there is a reason. I can hear the echo.
Now is it fine, ma'am?
Yes. So, hello, Manishi and Dr. Yashika. Happy Navratri and Dasara to everyone, and happy Thanksgiving in advance. Hope you are all doing well in this pandemic crisis and unprecedented times. I want to thank sincerely Manishji, the Managing Director, and Dr. Yashika, Managing and Content Developer, and Homeopathy 360 for Ka Home, and also for giving this Ka Homeopathy Study Group this great opportunity of sharing holistic approaches of healing through energy medicine. I congratulate Homeopathy 360 for the great accomplishment, and it is a wonderful platform connecting homeopaths around the globe with the latest updates and online services. I'm so glad to meet Manishji and Dr. Yashika this past January at HPWFSC conference. And homeopathy is divine art. So Yashika, shall I share the screen?
No, ma'am, your presentation is already visible on the screen. Okay. You can share, you can do next and previous from here only.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much. So today I would share something different. Like, can I go to the previous screen, please? Okay. So today's topic, A to Z quick tips to achieve thriving practice for homeopaths. So I would like to share my philosophy and spiritual things which made me to bring to this stage And in this 25 years of my homeopathic practice, which I would like to share, because you have been enriched with so much information on homeopathy, remedies and everything. So today's it will be a little different and chill down, and you will enjoy my experiences, the how I went through. So glad to be at JHC 2018 conference to speak about attracting clients for a thriving practice. At Phoenix, it was wonderful. And so the few things which I would like to share today with you are the main tips for achieving the thriving practice from my perspective. And we will go through alphabetical, philosophical, inspiring, spiritual words. And then we will try to find the rubrics based on those philosophical words and learning remedies from these rubrics and case studies and final considerations and questions. So few things which made me to that is important existence: challenge, code of ethics, discipline, disposition, decision, diet, earnestness, emotions, exercise, fast, forgive, friendship, faith, goal-oriented, God, heart, history maker, habit, happy, and honesty, individualization, joyful, kindness, learning, law of nature, leadership, mindfulness, mega living, mastery, mission, normal, nurture, openness, patience, professional conduct, passion, quickness, react, ready, another word, respect, silence, smile, strategy, strong, social intelligence, transformation, timing, trust, unity, unprejudiced observer, victory, vital force, vanity, warmth, willpower, water, walk, yoga, expert, you, yoga, zeal, and zen. So out of all that, beyond the limits, a challenge to prove oneself is the thing which I shared my experiences in this, and few things which I felt very important and that helped many of people like me when they move to different countries and they need to get adapted to that new situation, that nothing is impossible, and do not lose your confidence, and determination and hard work will help. So the main tips I would at higher level is, first one is niche. We should know how to present ourselves, the elevator speech, clarity in our communication as why we do what we do and how to solve the problems. Next one is passion, your charisma. Your goal is to find clients who believe what we believe and reciprocate our service as a healer and as a homeopath, acting in energy medicine. For every client you treat, consider homeopathy, homeopath's manifesto. Maintain only professional relationships with clients, set boundaries, and the purpose of interaction is to benefit the client. And building confidence with clients, build trust to restore their health. You should look fulfilled and balanced in your practice and without being resentful and drained, because you share your positive energy to the person with whom you're working. Your goal is to empower yourself and client through nature of interaction. Ideally, 10,000 hours of investment is needed for a successful practice. That is what the shows among the great people. Then collect the testimonials. Clients who report a 90% improvement happily give testimonials, which help other clients to pursue. And reference plays very important role from the existing clients. People follow the lead of others from whom they trust and make decisions. Study groups and practitioner networks are very important. Identify hurdles in your practice. Get associated with the local practitioners and like-minded people. That is very important. Our brain and intelligence show grow when we fail and struggle to succeed. And as you all know, failure is stepping stone for success. Research by Dr. Carol Dweck, professor of psychology at Stanford University, shows two mindsets. One is fixed and growth mindset. Fixed mindset is based on the genetics. He is either smart or not, and focus on tasks with high success and avoid tasks with risk. And growth mindset, capability and intelligence can be grown by effort, struggle, and accepts mistakes and failures. Advanced technology, creating website, marketing strategies, make client forms electronic, writing articles, blogs in local areas, community websites, advertising in souvenir, sponsorship to the youth activities by sharing knowledge in homeopathy, advertising in social media. You all know Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, all the things you can share, Instagram, Pinterest, LinkedIn. And special attention, because you care your clients. Being authentic by clicking clients, by checking their client status, reliability, and interactions, sending them birthday cards and out of office notification, giving hope, courage, and building trust in clients. Doing charity work in temples and churches, non-profit philanthropic organizations to promote awareness of homeopathy. Now coming to our philosophy. Attitude is everything. Change your attitude, you will change your life, by Jeff Keller. I really like his book. Be mellow and the world will be sweet to you. Achieve all the time by fulfilling your dreams. Always be an achiever. Accept the limits life brings to you. Do not dive in rage. That is the first thing which I did in my life. Accept the truth. And be unattached for mental peace. So whenever I fulfill the mission, I just leave the organization once it is completely full. It doesn't matter whether it's a presidency or anything. Do full justice, fulfill everything. And then, because no, do not attach to anything, any position or anything. And life is all about art of losing. So being in software for 10 years, which really paid me so much, and I was so happy, healthy, energetic. I got everything. I have my homeopathy and everything. But after 10 years and after I fulfilled my vision, I left. That is the art of losing that makes you free, happy, and move forward in life. So let us see a rubric. Mind justice makes strange attitude and position possessed as if. And the one remedy which is fine is stramonium. And from Shankaran's plant remedies, we have, it belongs to Solanaceae, and all the nature like violent terror and explosive fright, sudden danger, it is mostly seen in this remedy. Something happens sudden and with great intensity, and fear of darkness, explosive bursting. And other remedies in this Solanaceae family are belladonna and nicotinum hyoscyamus, capsicum dulcamara. And we see both passive reaction as well as the active reaction paralyzed. Since this today's topic is not getting in depth of the remedy, but we are finding what is coming up in our homeopathy, all the different rubrics and how the client behaves. And the active reaction is sharpness and passive is paralyzed. So from soul of remedies, we can see that stramonium patient feels helpless, like a child left alone, and there is impression of danger. Rubrics, delusion is alone in the wilderness, and child clings, awakens, terrified, knows no one, clings to those near. And delusion, animals jump out of the ground, and dogs attack him and biting, and always feeling that fright of animals. Let me share a small study. Of a boy. So about 5 years old was diagnosed with autistic spectrum disorder at 2 years and 6 months with the ear infection. And his right ear tube surgery at age of three. He's very is hot and sensitive and with the painful ears. But the emotionally, like he stays at one play, one angle and hyper and laughs immoderately. So one thing is he gets angry whenever his mother or father tickles. and warm body, and he wants to be naked and has sensory issues. And his ear tubes inserted and the fluid comes out of it. Nasal discharge is there, and which can turn a color to a different colors, yellow and green, and he has high fever, and in the past, high fever with convulsions. Another thing is seen in this client is organizes things in place, and he's shy, hides himself. So general, using the repertorization, complete repertory, we come up with rubrics, laughing, involuntary, activity, mind activity, hyperactivity, affectionate, children kiss and wants to, eye staring, hyperesthesia, eustachian tubes, elbow discharge, and generalities, warm aggravation. And we can see the all the remedies coming from all the phosphorus, hyoscyamus, belladonna, stramonium, which has covered all these rubrics to greater extent. And but when you see the Zomia software, I like it, and also Mac repertory and reference work. So it's a wonderful software. Mind, anger, tickle, and pinched being is seen in the stramonium. Cheerful, gay, alternating, and delirium found point staring and hides himself. And when you see the Roger Morrison's this one desktop guide, all this, for me the font is small. Okay, you can see the symptoms, fear of dark and all these things. Yashika, can I, is there any way I can make it bigger?
Ma'am, I just check if I can zoom it.
Zoom it? You cannot read.
Zoom kar lijiye.
Where is it?
Okay. Ma'am, there is an option Zoom ka, but it is not Zoom. Main try kar rahi hu, but ho nahi raha hai. Anyways, ma'am, we can do screen share also. If you want me to share your screen and Zoom it for you, I can open this slide and share it.
So I, you can see my screen, right? No, you cannot see my screen.
Okay. No, I cannot see. On the screen share, ma'am. Okay.
Screen share option, where is that one?
Screen share option is on the screen only above where you turn on the video and audio.
Okay, turn screen share option. Okay.
Just select the inside screen again, and share button will become blue.
Can you see me or no?
No. I can see you only. I cannot see the screen of yours. If you want me, I will help you out. I can open your presentation and then I can show you. I can show this slide. Ma'am, share your screen ka option you have, na? There will be a new window which will occur. Which will open, you need to select the inside window that is saying your entire screen again, and then the share button will become blue.
I am doing that. Something is
wait.
Hello?
I will show you my screen, ma'am. For the time being, I will show you my screen.
Sorry, I'm not able to see the window whichever I'm using right now.
Are you able to read now?
I'm not.
Hello?
Yes.
Can you read now, ma'am? Or can you see my screen?
I can, yeah. So, yes, I can see you. Your, okay.
Yes.
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 Okay. So, I did share screen, and then you can see my screen, right or no?
No, no, ma'am, I cannot see your screen. Can you please turn it on?
I did. Okay.
I would request the audience to please wait a minute. Yes, I can see now, ma'am. Yes, yes, yes. Great.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Always learning new things and old things. Okay. So you can see the screen, right? And from the Roger Morrison's desktop guide, we can see the things like fear of death, fear of dark, fear of bottom, and fear to be alone, and the complaints after fright, stammering, and other symptoms. So now, interacting. Now, and I need to navigate, right? And differentiating between hyoscyamus, stramonium, and belladonna, like more delirium is seen in belladonna, and when comparing to the other remedies, angelus is more prominent in hyoscyamus, and suspicious is more in the stramonium, and suspiciousness is there in the hyoscyamus. Fear more prominent in belladonna and stramonium, and we know that more inflammatory belladonna and non-inflammatory hyoscyamus. Belladonna 30C was repeated in water 2 to 3 hours interval, and which helped to reduce the ear pain and inflammation. And after 2 weeks, he was given stramonium because it was covered all the symptoms and went with the higher potency based upon his emotions and mind symptoms and intensity. And follow up after 2 months, child is more calm and less hyper and very happy. It was repeated whenever the symptoms relapse. So acute homeostasis.
Hi, we have a son.
I think this will take long time, so let me. Apart from his autism, but the mother is happy and she referred a lot of clients. I will skip.
So
mind and body, homeostasis has happened and he's happy. Okay, now the next one is believe. Believe in yourself, the first secret to success. Believe in God and believe in yourself. Believe what your heart says. Count your blessings, not your problems, and balance your life at all levels. So let us find a rubric, okay? Mind life believes all she says is lack cananum. Short case study. So she is 49 years old and has left breast cancer, Benin, anxiety about her health, and she thinks that it's an incurable disease. She's having dreams of known people and wants to be in the family, anticipation and envy about others, sensitive emotionally, and she's having pharyngitis with inflammation of the throat alternating left and right sides, and she feels better with cold drinks. Controlling, wants to have control over the situation, otherwise feels confused and panicky and do not want to be alone, wants appreciation, holds feelings inside, loves dogs, fear of snakes, and PMS symptoms, swollen breast. And another thing is she feels like I do not want to be a victim. And ravenous appetite, desires spicy food. So let us do the kingdom classification. Every time I compare myself with others, I feel I should become thin. I envy thin people. I hold the feelings inside. I retract back. I do not want to be a victim. All these tries go to the mostly the animal kingdom. Craves attention and needs the family and very excited when with people when she's around. So remedy given was lactaninum 200, 3 doses. Follow up after 1 month, she was very happy. And symptoms whichever she told has reduced, and symptoms which she did not tell also felt better. So like she used to feel weak and low energy, that got better, which she did not tell in the during the consultation, and she referred 3 more clients. We see hysterical, aggressive type, pharyngitis and headaches, and all the modalities, and sensation of floating as in vertigo, as if, and main fear of snakes, fainting, which is also seen in the argentum nitricum, aversion to touches there. This is spicy food, and alternating sides, back and forth, and inflammatory symptoms, PMS, all covered by the lactaninum. And in part of Materia Medica, you see things, whatever she says is a lie. It's a delusion. That feeling is there. and makes mistakes in writing and speaking. Every symptom seems a settled disease, and fear of disease is there, falling downstairs or as if walking in open air. Physical insecurity, deletion, she's dirty, always washing the hands. Like syphilis, always washing the hands all the time, and do not want to touch, and even aversion to touch oneself. Tries to overcome feelings by acting extroverted, aggressive, changeable moods, fear of insanity, alternating symptoms again is seen. The third one, confidence. Be self-confident, never lose your sweetness. Maintain code of ethics at all times, in at your workplace, in the organization, and everywhere. Life is a challenge. To be a better person, challenge yourself. Anything that comes in your life, just take it as a challenge and try to find out the ways you can get along. See, if you need an inspiration, and if you do not get it from others, you be an inspiration to others. And confidence, let us find a rubric. Mind confidence, want of self, after failure, Ambra Gracia. So I did pick all these single remedy rubrics from Zomio and also from Mac Repertory, where we can find with the our philosophy and the homeopathy. Prematurely old and senile, and ask questions but does not wait for the answer before saying something else. Silly loquacity, averse to company, especially when defecating. Cannot pass stool in the presence of the nurse. That is mostly seen in the Ambra Gracia and in the public restrooms. And worse from conversation, participating or hearing. And other symptoms is anxiety company in, and we have seen like any other animal remedy qualities, we see all these one, timidity, bashful, fear of strangers, and modern society girls, stranger presence of aggravates, embarrassment aggravates. The fourth one is discipline. Discipline yourself, mind and body. And good disposition, make right and best decisions at the right time. That makes a big difference in your life. Good and healthy diet keeps you with healthy thoughts. In Organ of Medicine, aphorism 210 to 230, Dr. Hahnemann mentions diseases of the mental and the emotional levels. 210, patient's disposition is to be noted, and 211, mental disposition determines the selection of the remedy. So, can we see a rubric with the discipline? Okay, mind discipline, easy to Natramur. All right, and we know about Natramur, merely thematic metamedical ailments from irritability, disturbed, aversion to being, irritability when questioned. Few symptoms like anxiety, salvation about, accusations, dreams, crimes, remorse, past mistakes, and dreams, reproaches himself, and face expression guilty, torments himself. Hateful to persons who have offended him, and sad during menses without cause, reserved, hypochondriac, and worse when consoled, dwells on the past, unpleasant memories, awkward in talking, hasty, drops things from nervous weakness, absent-minded, thinks he is pitied for his misfortune and weeps, abrupt, think ideas, and alternating mental conditions, forgetfulness, aversion to men in females. The other one is earnestness. Be serious. And mind seriousness, rubric, earnestness, morose, aurum. Intense hopelessness, depression, disgust of life, talking of committing suicide, and suicidal thoughts, peevish, vehement, unleashed contradiction, cheerful, alternating, broody melancholy, alternating with irritability, weeping, and praying and self-reproaching from heart disease. It is very good. And loquacity, rapid questioning without waiting for a reply. Fears the least noise, weak memory, totally awakes, changing mood, and she does everything wrong. Things are neglected. Something, her friends, her duty, hateful, quarrelsome, and everything looks dark for them. Number six, fast. Do not procrastinate. Do things fast that are of high priority. And forgiveness is something you do to free yourself. Friendship is a priceless treasure and you need it. You need to have a good friends in your career and at every time in your life. Faith in yourself and in God. Can we see a rubric? Okay, mind delusions, imaginations, walking. Someone walks behind him when fast walking. Stephis agria. Always angry, sensitive emotionally and physically, hypochondriasis, imagines insults, irritable, nervous, great indignation about the things done by others or by himself, grieves about the consequences, believes he will lose his fortune, his wife will leave him, and ailments from reserved displeasure, ill effects after scolding or punishment, afraid of his own shadow. Number 7, gratitude. Be grateful for the life you have. The more you are close to God, the more God is close to you. Ramana Maharshi. And be goal oriented. Keep always your goal in your mind and work towards it. Can we see a rubric? Mind delusions, imaginations, life, transcend is. Must reach his goal to be remembered. Ignis. Could not find a good picture, but this is okay. We can see that fire in this person. Ignis alcoholics, fire has been used as a means of sending messages and offerings to heaven. Fire represents truth. Deeds he could do great, as if he thinks, and desires beautiful things, finery, dictatorial, love of power. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come follow me. Number 8, heart. Put your heart in your mind and follow the lead. Be happy, not because everything is good, but because you see good in everything you do. Be a history maker by your choices. Create a habit of success by 21-day rule. Anything which you do for 21 days continuously, then it becomes a habit. And may honesty be your footprints on planet. Let us check your rubric with heart. Mind anxiety, motion aggravation, heart complaints in digitalis. Anxious about the future, with heart complaints, sadness, sleeplessness, from unhappy love, worse from music, fearful, feels as if he would fly to pieces, fear of suffocation at night and wants to be alone, despondent. Every shock is felt in epigastrium. Great anxiety, like from troubled consciousness. Number 9, individuality. Be unique in your own way. Others will follow you. Can we see a rubric? Mind individuality, sense of, and LSD. There are other more remedies in this one. And lysergic acid, acute LSD poisoning, excitement, hyperactivity, restlessness, and intentional thinking of process, disruption of orderly intentional thinking of process, quality of hypomania with flight of ideas, incoherent thinking, paranoid ideation, fearful, suspicion, grandiose behavior, euphoria with liability and abrupt switches from happiness to sadness, and in the later stage, great depression of mood. Number 10, joyful. Smile more, worry less, give more, expect less, and be in moment. Okay, let us see a rubric. Mind joy alternating with irritability. Cyclamen. We see in cyclamen, dull, sleepy, morose, joyous feeling alternating with irritability. Sadness as if he had committed a bad act or not done his duty. There is silent weeping and the room seems too small. tearful over the imaginary things, and again they feel like alone and persecuted. Number 11, kindness. Be kind and world will smile at you. Mother Teresa, her beautiful smile. We'll see a rubric, mind weeping, tearful mood, children in, when kindly spoken to, Silesia. And that they're introverted and displays characteristic of refinement, caution. They usually possess strong ethical sensibilities and they hold very strong opinions and rarely oppose them on others. Delicate but determined. Yielding, sensitive, weeping mood, and headstrong. Children cry when kindly spoken to, with physical weakness and torpidity. Loss of self-confidence and starts from slight noise, screaming, hopeless, disgust of life, wishes to drown herself. Brain fog is there and cannot express himself correctly, and complains from anticipation. Beautiful thing being kind and mindfulness. Number 12, be a successful leader. Be good to others and good comes to you. Law of nature. Always consider yourself a lifelong learner. So whatever I did so far, I just feel like I'm still a learner and I need to achieve many more things and consider many more people as role models. We'll see a rubric. Mind forgetfulness learned. Repeat cannot what he by heart. Mesirium. Ellen's encyclopedia, very sad about Mesirium. Feels very sad, indifferent to the whole world. Hypochondriac, takes no pleasure in anything. Everything seems to him dead. Everything vexes him and he wants to say all kinds of annoying things. Forgetful, was unable to recollect what had very recently occurred. Inclined to quarrel, intellectual and wary of life and loathing for death. Number 13, mindfulness in deep peace. We do meditation to get being mindful meditation. Lead a mega living life to enjoy to the fullest. Make smart choices that can bring you success. Accomplish your mission within reach. Be mastery in of your own life. We'll see a rubric, mind confusion, involvular heart complaints, chelidonium, plus materia medica. Remarkable tranquility of mind in chelidonium for 2 or 3 days, followed after a while by ill humor, low-spirited, desponding with inclination to weep, absent-minded, restlessness, felt she had committed the unpardonable sin, stitches and lancinating pains in the cardiac region and heart in pectoral muscles with the tightness of chest. Number 14, normal, motherly nature. The pure love and nurture yourself and nurture other practitioners, make them and help them to grow along with you, to inspire them. We'll see a rubric, mind dullness, morning rising on and after earlier than normal, Mentha Piperita. Activity desire for passionate, which combines excitement, pleasure, and excitement, vivid, pleasant, tremulous, exhilaration, rush of ideas, loquacity, enjoyment, excitability is more prominent, and fright and anxiety and unpleasant surprises. So from Maximus, ambitious, ardent, imagines that appreciated that she is not appreciated, and dreams that body parts, teeth falling out. Most of the clients, they come out with this rubric symptom. Narcissist, passionate, and work of desire, fermented. Reproaches himself, accomplished enough. he had not. Number 15, openness. Be open to changes. And we'll see a rubric, mind, anger, open air, desires. Anakadyam. Fixed ideas, things he is possessed of two persons, of two wills. There is no reality in anything. All appears like a dream. Suddenly forgets names and those around her, what she has seen, and aversion to work, lack of self-confidence, absent-minded, contradictory impulses, and laughs at serious things, melancholy and cruel, unsocial, neurotic, suspicious, very easily offended, and refuses to eat for fear of being poisoned. See in other remedies, like Erastox and other remedies. Hi, Simon. Number 16, patience. Never lose your patience. And always maintain good professional conduct. Be passionate in whatever you do. We'll see a rubric. Mind play, gambling, passion for cards playing. Brosimam Gaudichadi. Common name is Mama Kadela. I haven't given this remedy to anyone. If anyone has experiences or given, they can share later at the end. So Brosimam Gaudichadi, it is mostly used in the pharmaceutical industry and for the treatment of vitiligo, dreams of money, and play, gambling, passion for censorious, critical, company aversion to misanthropy, misfortune, dreams disaster, is pessimistic, and always dreams of money and gambling passion for. Discourage irresolution with doubtfulness, company aversion to. Number 17, quickness. Be quick in your actions, but be precise. So we'll see a rubric that goes with in from complete repertory. Mind answering abruptly, shortly, curtly, quick after uterine hemorrhage, sepia. Undertakes things opposed to her or his intentions, anger from contradiction, indifference to loved ones, care is full of about domestic affairs, and pathic repertory, busy when ameliorates sadness over one's health. Lying on hands and knees ameliorates sadness, domestic affairs, over desire for bitter drinks, will contradiction of and weeping when telling her symptoms, irritability, consolation, aggravation, hysteria, and indifference to everything. Fear of poverty is also seen, like we see in the calcarea flora and other remedies. Number 18, react. Do not react, but respond. There is a difference. Immediately reacting and then responding by thinking and giving the right answer. Be ready to embrace all opportunities and respect, self-respect always maintain at any place. You respect and take respect. So we'll see a rubric, the nerves, exhaustion, vital forces, loss of power to react. Capsicum. Capricious and changeable mood. Homesick with a red face and sleeplessness and disposition to suicide. Peevish, irritable, easily angered and offended. Awkward, runs into everything. Dipsomania, always on the lookout for insults. If she wants a certain thing, she will oppose. And if proposed by someone else, laughs and, like when it is proposed, she will oppose. Laughs and weeps alternately. Passive reaction is anesthetic, stupefied, numb, dead, stupefaction, cowardice. And active one is escape, flee, flight, run away, shrieking, starting in sleep, rage. Number 19, silence. Sometimes silence is the loudest reply. Keep smiling. And smiling is the secret of our life. Of whoever great people you see, they smile. And we try to do the same way to keep ourselves also smiling. Always have a strategy in your plans, and that really helps for making your success and reach your goals easily. Be strong and believe in your insights. ability to know about yourself and others. Social intelligence is very important. Homeopathy cures a larger percentage of cases than any other method of treatment and is beyond doubt safer and more economical and the most complete medical science by Mohandas Mahatma Gandhi. His beautiful smile. We'll see a rubric, Mind Smiling, Weeping with Pulsatilla, Windflower. And carried desires to be delusion alone. She's always and neglected his duty. He has the delusion and despair, religious despair of salvation, fear of men, and forsaken feeling, silent submissiveness, selfishness, yielding disposition, weeping, consolation, amelioration, and the childishness, ailments from jealousy. Number 20, transform. Transform to new beginnings. Do right things at right time. And be trustful as your gift to the world. Being trustful. We'll see a rubric. Mind delusions, imaginations changed everything has. Growing and transforming. AIDS. Vermulence Monira, desire for company of his family, of close friends of the group. Delusion that of being above it all, of not being appreciated, of not belonging there, of being a child, of being friendless, of being naked, unprotected, and exposed as if in a strange land, tranquility. Dwells on his childhood of past disagreeable occurrences, and eating in company, amelioration, fear of high places like Argentine nitricum and claustrophobia, fear in narrow places, hopelessness, and desire to kill everyone he sees. Number 21, unity. We grow when we are united. And be an unprejudiced observer, take unprejudiced decisions. We'll see a rubric. Mind and disposition, vexation. Past vexations arise from most indifferent thoughts and from every occurrence in life. Unite with new vexations, cannot free herself from them. Sulfur. From Herring's guiding symptoms, depressed about his illness and out of humor, melancholy, dwelling on religious and philosophical speculations, anxiety about soul salvation, indifferent about others. Imagine she has everything in abundance. Too lazy to rouse himself and too unhappy to live. Hypochondriac mood and during the day and merry in the evening. Hypochondriasis after suppression of eruptions. Weary of life and sadness without any cause. Dread of being washed in children, peevish, irritable, quick-tempered, fault finding, and great disinclination to speak, ill-humored. Number 22, victory. Be in right path, it leads you to the victory. Keep your vital force at highest spiritual level. Vanity and pride walk together. We'll see a rubric, mind vanity, make up too much like a podium. Confidence, lack of confidence, egotism, sentimental, cowardice, fear, people of contemptuous and hard for subordinates and agreeable, pleasant to superiors or people he has to fear. Dictatorial, love of power, fear being alone and undertaking any new things, hurry while eating, timidity appearing in the public and thanked when weeping and weeps ungratefully. Pathic, stranger presence in Pathic's Metamedica, any stranger in presence of them aggravates. Number 23, warmth. Share your love and warmth. Have strong willpower like a lion. Where there is a strong will, there is a way. Strong will. So, and another one is be like water, like Bruce Lee said, adapt to the whatever it is. So, be like water and infinity walk, number 8 style in Siddha Yoga. So walk in this number 8 style, which is really helps for the concentration and coordination, balance, and so acupressure points are also there, which really helps. We'll see a rubric: mind dullness, warmth, amelioration. Sambucus. From sentence, plant remedies, plants. Sudden violence, unexpected, mostly seen sudden and unexpected, sudden blow and attack, so ferocity, vehemence, cruelty, all this are seen in this remedy. And snagging, strike, beat, hurt, injury, catastrophe, disorder. Gentle motion ameliorates and warmth ameliorates. Number 24, expert. Be an expert in whatever you do. So, xenophobia is a fear of individual. One in is accustomed to. So, Robin Michaud. Few remedies for this xenophobia are Beretta cup, causticum, fear of strangers, all this, carbovich, cupramet, and caliphas, gelsemium, pulsatilla, thuja. Number 25, you are very important and blessed by God. You are worthy. You are someone who you are the only version of you to ever exist in the universe. You are very special. You are great. Yoga is self-realization, and it is needed for our well-being and to be healthy and in homeostasis. We'll see a rubric: mind and disposition. Child does not want to be touched, cannot bear you to come near it, desires many things which it refuses when offered. Chamomilla, of course, Sina is also there. Chamomilla patient experiences injury from insult, humiliation. In turn, the chamomilla patient insults, hurts others, and becomes rude and abusive because he perceives he's receiving injury from others' offenses. And compositive family and typhoid miasm, anger, irresponsibility, children in, and when carried, become bent backward, kick when carried, throw everything off, and carry desires to be fast. Capriciousness in children. Number 26, zeal. Do things with zeal. Zen is philosophy of reality. We'll see a rubric: mind and disposition, excitement, motion, quick, brisk, performed with uncontrollable zeal. Securitas Virosa. Shankaran, soul of remedies. The theme of Securitas is that the patient has been hurt so deeply and horribly in the past by another human being, especially a man, that she regresses into a childlike state and shuts out the rest of the world. In Pathak's Metamerica, childish behavior, mourning, dancing, shouts, and excessively affected by sad stories, mistrust, and confronts present with the past. All right, we're almost done, and this is about the CAST study group and all the which Dr. Yashika has already mentioned. And we provide continuing educational certificates for both CSC and non-CSC candidates, and we do non-profit educational webinars, case studies, and everything. And we bring world-renowned famous homeopaths, to name few: Dr. Massimo Manglivari, Dr. Divya Chabra, Dr. Ghanshyam Kalathia, Dr. Ganapati, Dr. Jawahar Shah, Dr. Farooq Master, Dr. Nancy Gales, and Dr. Shankaran, Dr. Girish Gupta, Karen Allen, and many more homeopathy stalwarts. So, good thing, like when I went to India, my college principal felicitated my silver jubilee. That is a great privilege and honor for me, and in front of Dr. Hanuman, a great tribute in my life, I would consider. And I always say a tribute to Dr. David Warkentin, as he always told me to remember him at all my places, achievements. He's the creator of the Max Repertory and Reference Work, and he passed in 2010. And I consider role models Dr. Rajan Shankaran and Dr. David Parkin and many more, which I learned from them and consider them as my inspiration and gurus. References, Shankaran's Plant Drug Remedies, Soul of Remedies, Pathak, Material Medica, Buriki, Herring's, Merlis, Theme of Thematic, Material Medica, Massimo's, Allen's Encyclopedia, Wormlands. So I will open now for questions. Yashika?
Yes, ma'am. Can you come back? Yeah, you are back to the software. Ma'am, do we have Shweta ma'am also with us? Shweta ma'am, are you with us? Yeah, welcome. We have Dr. Shweta Singh ma'am from Delhi with us. I welcome you ma'am on behalf of Homeopathy 316 Caste Study Group. So, ma'am, your audio is off, I think. Your audio is off. Thank you.
Honey. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for inviting me here, and this so nice to see Dr. Kavita here, and very nice presentation, and thank you for giving me this opportunity so that I can thank Dr. Kavita. She has achieved a lot with her hard work, and still she is so kind and down to earth. I feel very lucky, ma'am, to be associated with you as your team in Kavita Holistic Approach. And about today's presentation, the whole idea of explaining homeopathy from A to Z is itself so innovative and beautiful. You did justice to the whole concept, and I really, I thoroughly enjoyed your presentation. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Shweta. I hope I did not bore anyone.
No, not at all.
No, not at all. Thank you so much. We have Dr. Regina ma'am also with us, I think. Ma'am, are you with us? Can you hear me? By the time, I request the audience to please type your queries if you have any doubts from Dr. Kavita ma'am, so we can discuss in the end. Ma'am, Regina ma'am, yeah. Your audio is on. Hello, welcome.
Congratulations, it was a wonderful webinar. We learned a lot from you, and I want to try this Mama Cadela soon. I have clients with vitiligo, and I'm willing to try to see their response. I have a question. After you published your book until this present day, what did change in your life?
That is a good question. First thing what I like is I see happy when others are happy. So what happened was, after I published the book, it helped several clients like me. What you do not have, you give to others. What you want, you give to others. So what you do not have, when you give to others, you get. The nature will give you back. And this is a very good question. It's not appreciation from my college professors and everyone. They told me one thing. Kavita, I hardly count one or two people who went to USA who stopped. And when they got into the software, they just stayed there, because it is giving you everything. You get money. You are so happy. You learned the language or the thing you have. What else you need in life? Money, happy, health. That's it. You don't need anything. So they lost that profession. So, and other people encouraged me that, so home, you're giving such an importance to homeopathy, and to get certified in USA, you spent 5 years. Other person might have done in 5 months. So each person, their capacity, how they look at what is this. With 11 months baby, I have to babysit. But that is not my intention. I want to have my full practice, 8:30 to 5:30. I have my vision. Now what is this God is giving to me, and what I have to do? So this one, how I say to myself that I haven't done anything great. But when people are getting benefited with the homeopathy principle, see, every person will have problems in their life. I'm not the one. What I have is very small. I will say to myself. Just like the homeopathy principle, a person with a finger cut, when he looks at a person with a leg cut or anything, he says, oh my God, I am much better. So that is the homeopathy principle. So what I did was, as you said, Professor Regina, the book, how it is, every person, no one will put their day-to-day activities in the form of a book. What is special? What is so special of it, right? So that is where is thing. We grow, and how much time we have in life, we do not know. So everything at whatever it needs to be done at the age of 74, I wanted to do at the age of 37. So nothing great, but what you said is it is inspired. At least one or two persons, when they feel happy, that made me feel happy.
And things that money can't buy, right?
Money cannot buy.
Self-improvements you did. And now you're sharing with the world. When you give, you get back. Congratulations. You're doing a wonderful job.
And can I tell you one thing? When I compare to myself to the world famous homeopaths, I have done nothing great. In Indian tradition, there is a story with Lord Ganesha and Kumar Swami. So there is it. I do not know, Yashika, do you have time? I'm just, is it okay? How much time we have?
Just tell the story, please.
We have much time. You can share.
Yeah, and Yashika, we are not seeing your video. So then what happens? There is a thing like, who is the best? Who is the winner? Who is great? So then Lord, I know you all might have known this one, and I'm making a different version, but the concept I'm trying to give. So then Lord Ganesha, he's fat and everything. He cannot walk and everything. What he does is he just revolves around his parents and everything, his chants and everything. But Kumar Swami, he's energetic, he has talent, everything. And he has his vehicle. He revolves around the world so fast. But who is the winner is Ganesha, because of course I'm not saying that, I'm just making the point is, when you do not have much thing, but what you have, you use it. So here, that what we need to understand is, it is not that whatever God has given to you. So with that story, what we can learn is, if you do not have anything, knowledge or intelligence, that is fine, it's okay, but you have something special, each one. Yes. Go ahead, Yashika, any more questions? And we have next tomorrow Professor Regina speaking on Reiki, and we have beautiful thank you so much, Dr. Yashika and Manish James, managing director, and the whole homeopathy team for this, giving us this opportunity. It's a great honor for us.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I think we have not got questions yet.
Everyone might be sleeping.
So I would like to No, ma'am. Actually, the things were so clear. I myself have no such query. I think the doubts were already cleared. Still, I want to ask the audience to please type the queries if you have any. Ma'am, Shweta, ma'am, do you want to ask something, any query or any feedback you want to share?
I have just given my feedback already. She's so inspiring. We learned a lot from this lady. Thank you for that, ma'am.
You both are inspiring, and everyone here, Professor Rajan, everyone here are inspiring to me. Very inspiring.
This is your kindness, ma'am.
Learn. That is what, get depleted. When I get depleted, you are all there for me to inspire me. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Everybody is so talking about this topic. No questions at all.
We are enjoying a happy Dasara to you all. May God bless each and everyone, bring you health, happiness, and everything which you make you happy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I think we come to the end of this session of today. So we can wind up this session with you, everybody's permission. Shweta ma'am, Regina ma'am, and Kavita ma'am, maybe end this today's session. And tomorrow, I want to announce that we have another session at 8:30 sharp. So I would like to request all of you to please join us back tomorrow again, same timings, Indian Standard Time of 8:30. So kindly join us, and we'll be glad to share more knowledge and information. I think we have Dr. Regina ma'am only tomorrow, coming up tomorrow, na ma'am?
Yes.
Yeah. So we'll be learning about Reiki and many more things from ma'am, Dr. Professor Regina ma'am. So I hope you guys will join us tomorrow again. And for any queries, you can mail me at webinar@homeopathy360.com. For certificates, I would like to announce that we will be providing the certificates in the end of the complete series, that is on 3rd of November 2020. So kindly attend all the sessions, and then you will be receiving the certificates at the end of this series. So thank you so much, everyone. With due permission of all of you, ma'am, can we end the session?
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. I hope everybody enjoyed. Yes. Thank you, ma'am.